less than a bleeding situation when they qualify. The starting salary of a registered nurse, for example, is around £21,000 per year outside of London, compared to the national average graduate starting salary of around £25,000 per year. Add to this discrepancy between salaries, fees for registration, revalidation, DBS checks, indemnity insurance, and all the other things that healthcare workers have to pay for just in order to practice. Plus, the fact that loan repayments are now set to be taken through salaries upwards from £21,000 a year, you'll see that healthcare students are getting a raw deal from the moment they begin studying, beyond the qualification and well into their career. And that's not to mention the government's cap of a 1% pay rise per year for public sector workers. Why should healthcare students have to pay in the long term and work full time for the NHS? 50% of their studies have worked extremely hard at that. They shouldn't.
Before beginning to work in a job with a salary of less than £23,000. Lower these bursaries will mean a huge loss of talent and potential for the NHS. Mature students, people who already have caring responsibilities or previous debts, they may have the potential to be excellent NHS professionals, but without access to a bursary, their talents will be lost. There will be a much narrower range of people who will consider embarking on a career in NHS. And it won't just be nurses that are affected. We're going to end up with a shortage of physios, radiographers, occupational therapists, speech and language therapists, to name just a few. You know, I thought George Osborne, I think he thought he could get rid of student bursaries quietly. He thought that people wouldn't make too much of a about something that will only affect new students, but he underestimated people. NHS students know how important the bursary is in giving them the opportunities to train, and they're not prepared to see that opportunity being denied to future colleagues. Osborne thought that NHS students wouldn't care if the ladder of opportunity was pulled up behind them, but they do care because they care about people, and that's why they want to work in the NHS. And lots of people care. People want an NHS that has sufficient well-trained staff. They want the opportunities to undergo training and fulfil potential in a worthwhile job.
Hello everyone, my name's Phil, I'm a junior doctor. I just want to say on behalf of all my junior doctor colleagues, we stand in support of student nurses and all student allied health workers. We're sick and tired of not being listened to, and we stand together. All we ask is you do is stand with us as well. Thank you very much, and please guys, let's keep this going, let's keep this momentum.
Hi. So, obviously I wasn't expecting to speak today. I just wanted to say, our campaign at the University of Manchester at MMU is about promoting education as a public good, and it should be free at the point of use, just exactly as the NHS should be. I think, is it vitally important that we defend our right to education, a right to free healthcare, generally essentially to build on and create the society which we want to have. I think it's our duty as students, as workers, as the general public to support each other in these struggles. as we have these ideologically driven austerity attacks across the entire country. We need to stand against that. We need to recognise why they're doing them, why they're making these attacks. It's cutting down and it's a systematic oppression of the poor and the vulnerable, essentially.